Understanding rivers is like understanding the human body. If you just studied an arm or a leg, you wouldn't understand the functioning of the whole body. To study rivers, you have to understand the entire river, from the small streams to the large river, from the main channel to side channels. No one has ever attempted a study of so many rivers in so large an area. We're looking at 18 rivers, 9 in the United States, 9 in Mongolia. Some of the smallest ones will probably be about 300 miles long. The largest ones, certainly over 1,000.
The Kansas River coming through the prairies is very similar to rivers in northeastern Mongolia.
There are many ways that you can use this intercontinental comparison. One of them has to do with climate change. The river's temperatures reflect what happens in the atmosphere. Mongolian temperatures are increasing 3 times the North Temperate Zone average, so we can use that as a predictor for the United States. Understanding how their rivers function give us insights to how our rivers function. And right now, we don't have all the knowledge we need to manage rivers. This project will help with that.